Hi, this is Anil and welcome to the video tutorial for the Learning Lad on C++ programming. So in this tutorial we're gonna learn about the copy constructors in C++. So first of all, what are these copy constructors? A copy constructor is nothing but an overloaded constructor. You know, we have learned how to overload the constructors to take different parameters and different types of parameters. So this copy constructor is one of them. And the next thing is, what is the use of this copy constructor, or why we have to use this copy constructor? So before explaining anything, I want to show you the problem that's gonna arise if we don't use the copy constructor. So here, just for the demonstration purpose, you know, I have already created a class in my program, and the class name is person, and we have two public members called name and age, and then we have a constructor called person, you know, which is gonna take two parameters and is gonna initialize the class members. And then we have a method called change name and age, you know, which is gonna take two parameters and it's gonna change the value stored in these members. You know, it's gonna change the name and also it's gonna change the age. And then we have a introduce method, you know, which is gonna print out the value stored in these members. Alright, simple enough. The next thing that we're gonna do is, for the demonstration purpose, I'm gonna create an object of this class person. So here in my main function, I'm gonna write person, and let's say Anil, and we're gonna pass two parameters. First parameter is gonna be the name Anil, and then the age 24. The next thing that we're gonna do is, we're gonna call the introduce method. So it's gonna be Anil dot introduce. So here, you know, the value Anil will be stored to the name member, and the 24 will be stored to the age member of this object Anil. Now when we use this introduce method, you know, it's gonna print out the value. So I'm gonna build and run this. Hey, I am Anil and I am 24 years old. Alright, the next thing that we're gonna do is, we're gonna create another object. Let's say person duplicate Anil, and this duplicate Anil is gonna contain the same values as this Anil. So I'm gonna use the equal to symbol and I'm gonna write Anil. So now what we were intended to do is, we want to copy all the members of the Anil, you know, the name and age, and we want the exact copy in this duplicate Anil. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna use duplicate Anil, and I'm gonna call the introduce method. Now, you know, if I build and run this, hey, I am Anil and I'm 24 years old, that's from the Anil object. And then, hey, I am Anil and I'm from 24 years old, that's from the duplicate Anil. It means that, you know, when we use this equal to assignment, you know, all the members of this Anil object is copied to this duplicate Anil object. The next thing that we're gonna do is, we're gonna change the value of this name and age of the Anil object by using change name and age method. So here I'm gonna call the method, so it's gonna be Anil dot change name and age, and here I just wanna say Anil Shetty, and then I'm gonna pass age, let's say 100. Anil is 100 years old now. Now I'm gonna call this Anil dot introduce again, and then I'm gonna call duplicate dot introduce. So now if I build and run this, now you guys can see we get, hey, I am Anil and I am 24 years old, and the same thing in the second line, that is from this anil.introduce, and then the duplicate anil.introduce, you know, the value is exactly copied. And then we have changed the name and age of this Anil object, and that's why when we call the introduce method, it says, hey, I am Anil Shetty, the new name, and I am 100 years old. And then from this duplicate Anil object, we get, hey, I am Anil and I am 24 years old. So everything is perfect. So here we have the simple types, you know, the string and int, and we are not using any pointers, or, you know, we haven't used any dynamic memory allocation here. That's why, you know, when we use this type of simple members, you know, the allocation works as we expected. The next thing, or the problem, arises when we use the dynamic memory allocation. Here, let's say we're gonna have a pointer of this name, and we're gonna change the code slight a bit. So here in this constructor, we're gonna allocate dynamically. So it's gonna be new, and then string, and we're gonna pass the name. So here you guys can see, you know, this name is a pointer which is gonna contain a string value, and this age is a simple variable, that's it. And since it is a pointer, you know, we need to use the star operator here while changing the value. So it's gonna be star, and then I'm gonna use parentheses to group this name equal to name. And here also, when we refer this, we need to use star. Otherwise, you know, if this name is a pointer, it's gonna contain the address of the memory, you know, it's gonna print out the address. So to get the value stored in that pointer, you know, we're gonna use the val at operator. Alright, now we haven't changed anything here. Now I'm gonna build and run this program, and now you guys can see it says, hey, I'm Anil and I'm 24 years old. That's from the Anil object, you know, when we created it and when we call this introduce method. And then we have created the duplicate object of that Anil using the equal to, and it says, hey, I'm Anil and 24 years old. Fine. Next, we have changed the name and age of the Anil object. So you guys can see name of the Anil object is changed to Anil Shetty and age is 100. And when we call the introduce method, it says, hey, I'm Anil Shetty and I'm 100 years old. And then we just call the introduce method from the duplicate object. What do we get? We get, hey, I'm Anil Shetty and I am 24 years old. Look at this, you know, this duplicate object's name property is also changed when we change the name of this Anil object. So, and also, you know, the age is not changed. Age is still 24 in the duplicate object, and it is 100 in the original Anil object. So it means that when we use the pointers as the class members, and we use the dynamic memory allocation, and also when we copy the object, at that time the bit by bit copy takes place. And that's why in this Anil object, you know, the name is containing a pointer, you know, a memory address, and that's why that memory address is copied to this duplicate Anil's name member. So at that time, you know, both objects are containing the memory address of a same string. So it is Anil Shetty, you know, which is changed by our change name and age method. So that's why the name property of this Anil and this duplicate Anil's object are pointing to the same string. So we don't want that. What we want is when we create a new object and assign the values of one object, both objects should contain different values. And if we change the value of one object, and it should not reflect in another object. So it means that there is a problem when we copy one object to another object. You know, the same problem occurs when we pass an object to a function by copy. At that time, you know, the copy takes place, and the same problem. And also if a function is returning any object, at that time also same problem occurs. So what is the solution? The solution is to use the copy constructor. A copy constructor is nothing but an overloaded constructor. And this copy constructor is called whenever we copy an object of that class. So to define a copy constructor, you know, since it is a constructor, it has the same name as the class. So it's going to be person. And then, you know, it's going to take an object of this class by reference. So we're going to use the constant keyword, you know, just to make sure that the value of that passed object should not be changed. So it's going to be const, and then person, the object of the same class type, and then let's say p, and we are taking it by reference. So here, you know, this copy constructor will be called whenever we copy an object of this class. So here what we can do is we can make sure that when we use the pointers as our class members, the different memory should be allocated to that member. So here what we're gonna do is when we copy, we want to allocate an entirely different memory, and we want to copy the string. To do that, here inside this copy constructor, I'm gonna write name equal to, and then I'm gonna create a new string. So a different memory. So it's gonna be new string, and in that string, what I want to store? I want to store the name of the object that we are copying. Here, In this case, you know, when we copy that here, you know, this anil object will be passed. So this p is going to contain the anil object. What we want to store in the name member of the duplicate object, we want to store the name of the anil object. We can get that by using p dot name. So this p dot name is containing the address of a memory location, you know, which contains the name. So we want the name, not the memory address. That's why we can use the value at operator here. That's it. And the next thing is, you know, this copy constructor will be called whenever we copy one object to another. So here, that's why if we don't initialize this age at that time, you know, the age variable of that copied object is going to contain garbage value. So we're going to initialize that one also. So it's going to be age equal to p dot age. So here we're not using the value at operator, you know, because this age is not a memory address. It is containing a value. So I'm going to save this. I'm going to build and run this program. And now you guys can see, you know, when we create a new object of this anil and call the introduce method, it says, hey, I am Anil and I'm 24 years old. And then we have created the duplicate object. And at that time, the copy constructor is called. So just to demonstrate that, I can add a cout here. Copy constructor is called, and let's end this line, and also we need to add the semicolon in the end. Now I'm gonna build and run it again. Alright, now, you know, hey, I'm Anil and I'm 24 years old. That's from the Anil object. And then we copied the Anil object to duplicate Anil. At that time, the copy constructor is called, and the introduce method of the duplicate Anil says, hey, I'm Anil and 24 years old. You know, all the values are exactly copied. And then we have changed the value of the Anil object using the change name and age. At that time, the value of the Anil object has changed, and we can see that, hey, I'm Anil Shetty and I'm 100 years old, you know, the changed name and age. And then if we call the duplicate Anil, Anil's introduce method, you know, it says, hey, I'm Anil and I'm 24 years old. So now, because of this copy constructor, you know, these two objects are not sharing any same memory location. So both of them are containing different values in different memory locations. And also, when we won't define this copy constructor, you know, there will be a default copy constructor called by the C++, but you know, there will not be any statement. That's why, you know, the bit by bit copy takes place. So this is it, guys. This is about the copy constructor in C++. You know, why we have to use this, what's the problem that's going to arise if you don't use it, and also how to use it. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe, like my Facebook page at facebook.com/learninglad, and stay updated with the latest videos that we're gonna make, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.